I had long been a fan of Top of the Lake. I absolutely loved the first season. I thought it was a really exceptional piece of work. And Jane and I have a friend in common, and she put us in touch with each other. And I expressed my long-found love and admiration of Jane. And a few months later, she contacted me saying that she had written a part for me in the new series. Which was an absolutely wonderful thing to have happened to me. I could not have been happier about that. Miranda is, well, she was a challenge for me to play. She is a very vulnerable character. She is a woman who isn't really succeeding at life. She's finding life very difficult. She's quite alienated. She doesn't have many or any friends, and she finds life very difficult and struggles to be good at anything at all. It can be quite painful to play a part like that, particularly when it's been created for you. But I just found it to be such a fascinating exploration of womanhood, of what it is to be a particular type of woman, a woman that doesn't feel represented, a woman that feels maligned, a woman that's struggling, that doesn't feel supported. So it was a brilliant acting challenge after the amazing parts I've had in things like Game of Thrones and Star Wars, of women of real strength, that I was desperate for a challenge. And I'd said to Jane, I would really love a challenge next, and I got one.
You're working alongside an amazing cast. I mean, particularly, can you talk about working with Elizabeth, because your relationship with her is very crucial for both characters, I think.
I loved working with Lizzie, and it was such a real privilege, really. I had long admired Lizzie's work, and I absolutely adored her in the first Top of the Lake as well. I thought she was just exceptional. And I remember saying to people, she's great, that girl. She's so good in that show. I was very nervous about working with Lizzie because she's just so accomplished. She was hugely generous, and I really loved having the opportunity to work with someone who is so invested in the material and so invested in making it alive and taking risks and embracing the challenge. And I loved every second of it. And also, she was a lot of fun. We had a whole ton of fun together, and it was most wonderful being able to laugh with someone. Well, Jane's exceptional, isn't she? She's an auteur. And it was so interesting seeing her standing up there with all those men at the 70th anniversary of Cannes. There she was, the only woman to have ever won. I think what is brilliant about Jane's work is that it leaves you questioning. Long after you've left watching the screen, you thinking about the things that it's brought up, whether it's the images or the writing, just the way in which one particular character has behaved. It gives you so much pause to think and to really explore what the work might be about. This season explores so many themes: femininity, what it is to be a mother, mothers and daughters, friends, the intensity of a female relationship, the intensity of a workplace, death, birth. It's all in there, but it's also all wrapped up in a really gripping and thrilling and entertaining, bizarrely entertaining and strangely odd crime thriller. And that's what's so great about Jane's work. It's all a contradiction. I think really what people want to see is something other than the conventional now. I think that people are, may I say, a little bored of the homogenised view of the world that we seem to be being given a lot of until maybe the last few years. Brienne of Tarth is an incredible character. We see a woman who is unconventional. She's not conventionally attractive. She is not cute. She is not sexy. She is none of those things that gain you value points in our society. But she uses all of the skills that she does have to overcome that obstacle. And she, I think we all love to see the underdog triumph. And I think that Brienne of Tarth is, I think Brienne of Tarth encapsulates the underdog that all of us feel, or many of us feel more than others, and overcoming that obstacle. And I think that that's why we feel so delighted, is that we see for once in our lives those of us that feel left outside come out on top. I am over the moon to be part of Star Wars. I mean, I know everybody has always loved the films. I've loved them since I was 6 years old. Ryan is a brilliant director and a joy just to be around. So intelligent, forensic, but so warm and open. And I'm particularly delighted to play a character that, again, doesn't conform to traditional female norms. Even to the point that I remember Kathy Kennedy and I had a conversation where she said, have you ever Googled female heroines? And she showed me the results, and they were all women who were scantily clad. And I was particularly excited of the opportunity, just even as a concept, to have a woman where we respond to her not on the basis of how she looks at all. Not at all. It's just her actions. And I felt that that was a bold, brave and necessary move for Star Wars to make. And I'm so proud to be a part of that.